Hi boys and girls, Mrs. Palm Pang here, and today I thought we'd do a little drawing with form and line. So I'm going to be using today a Sharpie marker and a cup and three crayons, actually four crayons. I'm going to use the primary colors, which are red, blue, and yellow, and like I said, a black Sharpie marker, and that's all you need. So let's get started. The first thing we're going to do is use our cup and our marker, and we're going to draw a circle right in the middle of our paper. I like to use some things around the house to trace with. Now, inside of this circle, what we're going to do is we're going to make something about the size of a quarter. So it will be another circle inside here. And once you have the circle drawn, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go around that circle a couple times to make the line thicker. In line design, you always have the contrast or the combination of either thin lines, medium lines, or thick lines. And this is what gives your design contrast when you're using lines. The difference in thickness and length, the way they can be used in a pattern sometimes, and all add to your design using form with the shape. I'm doing this freehand, so it's kind of, might not be 100% even, it's kind of just taking on a style of its own, which is okay. So I have a thick line in the middle, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to practice the lines that we used last time we were together, the vertical lines and the zigzag lines and horizontal lines and diagonal lines. So starting from the top, what we're going to do is we are going to do a series of lines that are going up and down. So they appear vertical at some points, and then as they go down the side, they get slightly slanted on the diagonal. So we have them on the top. Now what we're going to do is add some symmetrically on the bottom. So below that, I'm going to do additional vertical lines that are, as they get up the circle, they get slightly slanted. Ooh, that's like a tongue twister. So I'm just going to go ahead and do that. Now we have those two sets of lines. Now what I'd like to do is I'd like to do another set on this side without enclosing the whole circle in these lines. So I'm going to just do a few here and a few on the opposite side. Now you can use any lines that we've talked about in the middle, but today I think I would like to choose to use a spiral line, one that goes around and around and around. So starting at the center, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start at the center and just kind of nice and slowly and controlled, make a nice spiral line right in the middle of that circle. This gives it a combination of some straight lines and some spiral lines, so they complement each other. For the outside circle, I'm going to go around the circle that I traced now with my Sharpie marker and make it a little bit thicker. Once again, we have that complement of thin and thick, and this line I'm going to just increase a little bit by just going around it a second time. Take your time, you don't have to rush. Going all the way around the circle. Now, after darkening the outer circle, kind of makes my lines look a little bit more pronounced. You can see them a little better when you have the thicker lines. I'm gonna go back into my circle now, and I'm gonna use some lines that are diagonal, and they're going to be in these spaces that I've left empty. So changing the direction of the line next to the other two sets that are going vertical and diagonal, I'm gonna go kind of horizontally across here. And then I'm gonna go ahead and do that other side. Now I'm doing this freehand, so the lines aren't 100% straight. They're kind of I guess, a little bit abstract looking or just kind of a little bumpy looking. That's okay. So I'm gonna finish and I'm gonna go on this side now. Now you can kind of individually decide, do I like my lines a little bit further apart? Do I like them thinner or thicker? How close together are they, right? So now we've filled in the circle. Let's work on the outside of our design. For the outside of the design, what I want to do is I want to create something that looks like an organic shape. So I'm thinking something that looks like a candle flame. And to get them even, what I do is I start one on the top, one on the side, one on this side, one on the bottom. And then to even them out, I'll put another one in the middle of these two that go all the way around. So one here and another one here. And I guess you could probably guess I'm doing another one here and one more. Now I have some space in between, and I think that this would look visually interesting if I put maybe a smaller one of the same shape. So in the space here, I'm going to see if I can put three more small ones. And the same over here. Going around. And continuing, I have two more spaces to go. Now, what would make this look really interesting is if we have some solid areas of contrast with my black marker. What I'm going to do is some of these shapes I am going to fill in a pattern. So I will do the larger of these shapes and I'm going to just divide them in half. So I'm making a line kind of halfway through there. And these shapes I think I will fill in solid. To alternate between dark and light. Once again, when I talk about contrast, that's what that means when you're taking something opposite and putting it together. It gives it a great complement, meaning they just make each other look good when they're next to one another. So using black and white colors together, it just adds something special to your piece. So here I've alternated the design, and now maybe I'll go in here and I will go ahead and fill in some other solid areas. So the little small shape in between the other two, I'm going ahead and I'm just going to fill that in solid as well. Time, and if your shapes look different than mine, that's okay. It's always good to just kind of put your own spin on your art. I always believe everybody's individual. Everybody's art is like their fingerprints. It's different. So now we have these. Now I'm going to go in between these shapes and I'm going to add a little bit of a bigger shape that's similar to these but bigger in size. Okay, now we have some larger shapes on the outside. In here, I'm gonna go back to my lines again, but this time I'm gonna do my lines
graduated in size. So I'll start with small lines, go to medium lines, and then some large lines. Watch how I put them. So down the center of this shape, I'm gonna put a long line, and then beside it, the lines are gonna go down in size. One in the middle, a medium, and a small. One in the middle, medium one on both sides, and then small on both sides. So now we're using different size lines. We use different size shapes here. Small, medium, and large. Now you can adjust your shapes in any type of drawing you're doing. These are just good skills and good reminders to have to make your drawings visually very interesting. Let's go ahead and inside here, let's create some straight lines. So I'm gonna do something that looks similar to a triangle. And outside of the shape, I'm going to keep going all the way around. It's okay to have things go off the page too. This design kind of is not very even, but that's okay. Still visually interesting. One side of my shape, I'm just gonna go ahead and add lines on. So it'd be the right side of these triangles. I'm just gonna add a shading kind of appearance on my shape. These shapes, I'm going to go ahead and fill these in solid. So they look like long rectangles. Once again, it just gives it the complement of light and dark. Doing a different shape, just make one side of it a little bit solid, filled in kind of dark. Just gives it that nice contrast. And I'm going to continue going around. And over here, I've got a couple more spots to fill in. I'm going to grab another marker and I'm just going to go ahead and fill in these areas here. And finally the last area on that side. So I'm just gonna go over here and fix that, and we have some more contrast. Now inside of these shapes, I think we should do some repetition. So I've chosen a circle. You are welcome to do different size circles in here. Once again, this is about form today, and we're using different size shapes. Small, medium, and large, and with line design. A lot of repetition.
And I'm gonna go up here and just finish these. In. Now you might want to add some lines on the outside. So on the outside, I'm just going to add some lines that are just kind of freeform. They kind of come up, curl over. I got a little touch of that spiral action in there, come up this way, and then maybe two small ones inside. I'm just filling in those spaces between the triangles with some simple lines. And then I have some just simple lines that are round, thin lines. So we have thin and thick. Okay, let's alter maybe some of these circles. They look kind of similar. So some of them, let's fill in an odd view solid just to kind of give it a little differentiation. Little spice, it's like salt and pepper kind of. You can fill in as many dots as you want. I kind of spread them out as I'm going. Take it easy while you're doing it. Breathe in and out through your nose, let it out through your mouth. Do some relaxing. I always like to make my art because it helps me to relax. So hopefully it does the same for other people. I know I really enjoy it. So now we have a little bit of, I don't know, some more contrast. Light and dark areas. And now wouldn't it be great to add some color into our design? Let's see. So I'm gonna go and I'm gonna get the three crayons I told you about, actually the three. So I have my primary colors here. I have yellow, I have red, and I have blue. Now we're going to start putting some color into this. So maybe in the middle, I'm gonna add some yellow. Now you are welcome to use any of the other two colors that you want. I'm just gonna start my design out with some yellow. So I'm kind of pressing really hard on my crayon. As you can see, my crayons have been through a lot, but they work great. I don't like paper on my crayons, and the smaller pieces I find are easy to work with. So with the yellow, let's add, I think I'm going to add a little bit of red. Maybe on the top, maybe a little bit of red on the bottom. Let's see, I think a little blue with this yellow would look interesting. Let's see what happens when we add blue and red, and blue and yellow.
red and yellow we added already. You can kind of see what happened there.
We got some color mixing going on there.
I'm gonna continue. Side of my crayon, I'm just gonna add my colors in. Remember, I'm only working with these three colors, and I'm gonna mix it. We're gonna try to make all the colors of the rainbow with these three colors. So I just have a blue crayon, little piece of one, little piece of red, and a little piece of yellow. I'm gonna add a tiny little bit of red over this blue. Red and blue, it will give you purple. I'm using different various pressures with my crayon. Some areas I'm doing a little bit lighter, some areas I'm doing a little bit darker. And I'm going ahead and mixing my red with my blue. I'm going to add some down here. So I'm using two colors together. So it's either a combination of the red and blue, or the red and yellow, the blue and yellow, the blue and red. What I'm really doing is just layering different color crayon over itself. And when you blend the crayon in a certain way, it will give you the other colors of the rainbow. As little or as less as you want. And now I have, let's see, I have some red and blue in those. I'm gonna add a little bit of yellow in and see what happens. Now I'm using three colors. I have the red already down and the blue, and then I'm just going back in and adding some yellow. So I'm kind of putting the colors over each other. And I'm starting to see other colors happening here. I don't know if you can, but hopefully you can. I have some oranges, I have some greens, I have some purples. Just what I was looking for. Back in and add a little more blue. I'm kind of alternating my crayons, and you kind of can do different amounts of pressure. If you want a brighter color, use a little bit more pressure. And if you want a softer color, then you would just apply less pressure.
Not too bad, right? Some color going on. Now, it looks kind of dark here, so I think a good idea would be to put maybe a primary color in here. So I'm just gonna use a little bit of yellow. And maybe another little bit of yellow. So depending on how much pressure you put in there,
like I said, you can get a very light crayon mark or you can get a very dark crayon mark. So you might be using a different color than yellow around your background, I'm not sure, but I just like yellow because it does make everything appear a little bit brighter. Put some real elbow grease into this, pressing really